episode 1610, Create Momentum in Your Marriage.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy every day. It is a brand new day, which means what? You have another chance to build a stronger foundation within your marriage. Are you ready to create momentum in your marriage? Let's dive in. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S.S. newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, once upon a time, you fell in love, and then life happened. There is hope, though, for a dynamic marriage. Get the spark back and create momentum in your marriage. But first, you have to answer the question, do you want real change in your marriage? And when I say real, that doesn't mean something that you have read in a novel that you're like, oh, if only my marriage could look like this, or something that you've watched on TV or Netflix. No, this is real life stuff, making relationships work. We can complain that our marriage isn't what we want. We can blame the other person for all the faults and failures created by them because, right, it's all their fault. We can use reckless words and critical statements to confirm all that we don't want. It's the fame of blame. Are you living in that world now, always blaming someone else? Maybe you even blame yourself. But most of the time, we try to point the finger at somebody else. However, change in a marriage begins with one person. Yes, I know, if having both parties participate, it would be much smoother. But in reality, you just don't always get that. So just because you're ready and your spouse isn't doesn't leave you hopeless. A lot of us are living that way, though. We think that, well, gosh, if my spouse won't go to counseling with me, then I can't do anything. That's totally false. And if you're getting that information from somewhere, then you need to close that area of your life because I know I've been down that road. I've been down the road of a hopeless marriage. I was told by multiple people who have been through counseling and working with couples, not just like one or two of them, but hundreds of them. And they looked at me and said, you know, we're going to be real with you. I was like, really? It doesn't look good. I was the only one carrying the hope. Today, I'm carrying that hope for you. But you have to be honest with yourself. If you're ready to make a difference, then you have to understand that real change starts with real habits, habits that add to the heart of the marriage. So you get to choose. Are you continuing to claim the fame of blame? May sound great. Do you want your star on the fame of blame? Oh, yes, I want my name there in lights. Or are you ready for a dynamite marriage, one that you may never get a star on the walk of fame when it comes to marriage? If you desire that dynamite marriage, then let's use some TNT. That is your KISS to Keep It Simple strategy. It's the TNT, the talk and touch. We forget how to do both of those. Because why? Life happens. Life gets in our way, but life is what? Life. We all go through it. We all have to go to a doctor appointment, or we have to pay bills. We have to clean the house. Eventually, we have to do the laundry. And sometimes we have to eat. Very rarely do we get to spend time doing just anything and everything that we want that puts a smile on our face. We have to deal with all the other yuck and muck, which is probably what? More than 75% of our time. When all of that stuff consumes you, that means life happens. But when you allow it to give power to your fame to blame, then that's when your marriage begins to break apart. Because you're focused on what? The faults, the failures, all the letdowns. It's easy to point out stuff that we don't like. If you go to a restaurant and you get a plate of food and you're like, you're eating it, and then all of a sudden there's something there, you just don't like it. You're like, you just start talking about, I don't like this, and I didn't like this, and I didn't like this. Very rarely do you say, this was awesome. Because unless if everything is awesome, we talk about the bad. Think about it. I know we're not sitting around the dinner table having this thought, nor are we having these discussions, because we don't think about it. And that's why we have our marriages failing, because we're not talking. We're not touching anymore. And I'm not talking about the touching that you think I'm talking about. We'll talk about that touching. But it's a TNT. In order to have an incredible marriage, your actions and words must connect. It's a charge to bring together. It's this cohesiveness. Have you ever had to turn lights on and start them yourself by like turning off the power? And I mean, I'm talking when I say start them yourself, like wire to wire, and there's a spark. That's what I'm talking about in your marriage. You want this ignition of electricity, this charge of connection to bring you together. It's relational electricity. It's TNT. So let's break it down. What is TNT? Talk and touch. Well, talk to your spouse with kindness and love. Talk all in love and kindness. T-A-L-K. I love that. Talk all in love and kindness. This is the verbal exchange with your spouse. And guess what? Your spouse doesn't even have to interact with you. The requirement is that the talk must build up and not tear down. It's all about what? Positivity. It's giving in to them, building them up. And so it might be saying, boy, sweetheart, you look incredibly awesome in that outfit. Something as simple as that. And mean it, not just sit there and say it to say it. Or thank you so much for taking out the trash today. When was the last time you thanked your spouse for taking out the trash? When was the last time you thanked your spouse for putting their shoes away? Whatever that they do often that you don't want them to do, and then all of a sudden they do it. When was the last time you said thank you? When was the last time you left a note for your spouse? As they're going off to work, you drop a little note in the briefcase or in the purse, or you put a post-it on the steering wheel. So when they get in, all they see is, hi, honey, I love you. Oh my gosh, that's talk. It's in love and kindness. And guess what? If your spouse is mad at you, you don't have to have their interaction. You can still do this. You can send a text message in the middle of the day. You can share your dreams. When was the last time you actually had a real conversation? Not about the bills, not about the children, not about the laundry, not about the football game or the basketball game or the dance activities. Not about any of that. Only about true life, connecting with dreams and goals and passions. My husband loves playing the guitar. Is he great at it? No. Is he learning? Oh, yes. And he has a heart for it. And I love that this is something that he has found recently. And so you could say we're beginning to collect a few guitars. His interest is there. Am I interested in guitars? I would like to play the guitar. I know enough to be dangerous. I'm musically inclined, but guitar was not my instrument. And so I kind of like talking about it, but I have other passions. But you see, because that's his passion, I mention things to him about guitars. It has nothing to do with me, but it means something to him. So I stay connected. I may see something that comes across Twitter. And I say, hey, do you know about this guitar? I saw it was a new release. And he'll be like, whoa, how did you know that? All of a sudden, what? It's this electricity, this spark, this ignition that ignites what? This little bit of, wow, you really do care about me. The TNT, the talk and touch. Have you done that talking yet recently? Probably not so much, because we don't. We let it fall. Now, what about the last T, right? The TNT, you got to have dynamite. There's two of them, talk and touch. That touch is a physical gesture given in love. It's a simple action that conveys you matter to me. It may be just a brush up against him in the bathroom as you're walking by. Maybe a little squeeze on an extra cheek. I'm not talking about the top cheek. I'm talking about the bottom cheek. And this touch, though, is not about your foreplay. Not trying to get more out of something. This is just, I love you. This is just because. A caress on the hand. A hey, and you rub your shoulders. A little back scratch. It all feels good. But it's that gentle touch, that tenderness, all given in love, that physical gesture. When was the last time you did that to your spouse? When was the last time you did that to your wife, your hubby? A lot of us aren't doing it. Why? Because life happens. It gets in the way and we don't think about it. When was the last time you climbed in bed, not expecting anything dramatic, but just grabbed his hand and held it and just kind of rubbed it a little bit? He may look at you strangely like, what's up? Nothing. I just wanted to hold your hand. That's it. Nothing else. It's amazing how giving that is and how fulfilling that is to the heart in a marriage. What are you doing for your marriage? Are you trying to walk the fame of blame? Are you looking for that star? Sounds great, doesn't it? Because most of us would qualify for that, and me too. And that's not something that I ever want to be proud of. That's one thing I really try to rid myself of. It takes work. There are days that I'm really, really good at it, meaning that I don't have any fame to blame. I am not on, I don't have that star, I don't have that marquee, nothing. But then there are other moments that it's like, whoa, it's decked out, lights, sirens, music, everything. It's jazzed out because all I'm doing is pointing out the failures and the faults. That doesn't do anything for a marriage. It's sabotaging. It's critical. It's destructive. And it can devastate a marriage in a heartbeat. If your goal is to build a strong foundation in your marriage, you got to include TNT. Talk and touch goes a long way. It's dynamite. You want that electricity back, right? I mean, go back to when you were dating. Go back for the first few years of marriage when you didn't have kids running around, when things were maybe a little hectic, but not so crazy like they are now. When you didn't have to make, you know, decisions that are life-changing for your family, whether it's a new job, buying a new car for a child, figuring out where they're going to go to college, maybe just what classes they're going to take in middle school, or what's their play date going to be. If you do not have this electricity within your marriage, eventually what happens? The light goes out. Why do you think that empty nesters have problems? Because their commonalities have now left the nest. What brought them together is no more. Yes, they're still obviously alive, but they're no longer under the roof. And so they don't know what it's like to talk. They don't know what it's like to touch. There is no dynamite. It's empty. You don't want to get to that point in your marriage where you feel like you've exhausted everything. These simple gestures, these simple kind positivity, verbal explanations, and conversations can change your marriage. If you want real change, you've got to create real habits. And one of the best ones is TNT. It's dynamite. It's awesome. Are you ready to incorporate that in your marriage? Now, maybe you don't know really where to start or what it would look like, because marriage is complicated. Relationships, I don't care if it's with a man and a woman as a relationship or it's best friends. You know, your best friend could, you guys can have some issues on that area too. Relationships are tough because we are dealing with what? Emotions. And emotions are what makes us unique. It makes us an individual. But it also makes it very tough to figure it out because we don't know what the other person thinks. We don't know how accepting they are of either what we're doing, what we're saying, how we're acting. If you're saying I kind of struggle in this area, click on the link, take aim in the show notes. I have a free gift for you. It's a coaching call with me. When you click on that link, that will begin our conversation. We'll set up a call, you and me. There is no charge to this. It's my way of saying thank you. Don't wait until it's too late. That's what my pastor told me when I walked in and told him that my husband had said I've fallen out of love. He said, when people come into my office at this point, because I'm going to be honest with you, it's usually too late. There's not much to salvage. I don't want you waiting until it's too late. Be proactive in your marriage. Start creating that electrifying energy, that relational electricity. Go out and light up your marriage with some TNT. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a dynamite day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.